Hi, darlings of DWPS. How are you all? I hope you're all healthy. Okay, let me think about the happiness. When we're all happy, then our face will surely show it. Now, it's a time to show your happiness. Okay, my dears, you all stand and show your happiness to your family members by singing the following as our class starter activity.
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it, if you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, stamp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, stamp your feet. If you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it, if you're happy and you know it, stamp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, turn around. If you're happy and you know it, turn around. If you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it, if you're happy and you know it, turn around. If you're happy and you know it, wiggle your hips. If you're happy and you know it, wiggle your hips. Show it if you're happy and you know it, wiggle your hips. If you're happy and you know it, stretch your arms. If you're happy and you know it, stretch your arms. If you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it, if you're happy and you know it, stretch your arms. If you're happy and you know it, pat your head. If you're happy and you know it, pat your head. If you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it, if you're happy and you know it, pat your head. If you're happy and you know it, touch your nose. If you're happy and you know it, touch your nose. If you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it, if you're happy and you know it, touch your nose. If you're happy and you know it, point your toes. If you're happy and you know it, point your toes. Shout hello.
Hello!
If you're happy and you know it, shout hello.
Hello!
If you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it, if you're happy and you know it, shout hello.
Hello!
Say hello.
Hello!
Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa.
Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Rivia.
Rivia.
Ni hao.
Ni hao.
Kalimera.
Kalimera.
Jumbo.
Okay, my dears, I hope you all enjoy. Okay, now we are going to start chapter 1, number system. Today, we are going to start rounding off numbers. That is rounding off numbers. Someday, you buy a big bunch of grapes. How would you share, you and your friend? Would take one grape each, then again one grape each. Generally, when you are with a good friend, you find a lot of joy in sharing. You don't try to count it. If someone asks you how many grapes you had, you make an estimation like 15, 20 as you haven't counted the exact number of grapes. Sometime in real life, we make estimation when we don't know the exact number of something. Likewise, there are 50 students in a class. There are around 1,000 people in our locality. But does the estimation is just guessing? No, it much more than that. Assume a farm owner told his helper Ramu to count the number of mangoes on the tree. He guessed there are about 2,000 mangoes. When picking the mangoes, the owner found out only there are 960 mangoes. He was very angry and thought someone has stolen on his mangoes. If Ramu has estimated properly 900 or 1000, there would not be any trouble. When estimating, we should tell something which is closer to the real value, as close to the possibility. Sometimes we know the exact value, still we use the nearest value. But there are 37,821 people in town, but 37,821 is hard to remember. So we can say there are approximately 38,000 people in my town, as it is very close to real number. Expressing a number by other number near to it, which is simpler to remember, is known as rounding of numbers, and the expressed nearer value of a number is known as rounded number. Like we told 37,821 roughly 38,000. So we rounded 37,821 approximately 38,000. So here 38,000 is rounded number and 37,821 is an exact value. But why we round 37,821 to 38,000 and not 37,000? What is the difference between 38,000 and 37,821? Let us write it down. 38,000 minus 37,821 is 179. Then what is the difference between 37,000 and 37,821? 37,821 minus 37,000 is 821. So obviously 38,000 is much nearer to 37,821 because the difference is less. So we said 38,000 is the nearest number to 37,821. You must think that, do we need always to do subtraction to find the nearest number? No. There is an easy way to find out the nearest number. Let us understand with a simple example. There are 18 students in our class. If someone asked approximately how much are there in your class, then you can say about 40 students. Is it right estimation? Let us use a number line to represent numbers from 30 to 40. See, this is 38. Is between 30 and 40. If you see closely, 38 is close to 40 as compared to 30. So we rounded 38 to 40. If 33 in your class, let us again check with the number line. This is 33, is between 30 and 40. If you see closely, 33 is close to 30 as compared to 40. So we rounded 33 to 30. Now, think about 35. If we see the number line, 35 is exactly midpoint to 30 and 40. So, we round up to 40. So, what did we do actually? We rounded the number to the nearest tens. If the ones digit is 4 or less, we round down. We need to remind the tens place unchanged, the ones digit becomes 0. For example, in case of 33, the ones digit is 3 and it is lesser than 5. So we left the tens place as the same and ones place become 0. Then 33 is rounded to 30. What when the ones digit is 5 or more, we nearest up. Then tens digit is increased by 1 and ones digit becomes 0. For example, 38, 1's digit is greater than 5, so we added 1 to the tens place and 1's digit becomes 0. So the nearest tens of 38 is 40. Let us take another example, 1765. We are going to round nearer to tens. So look at the last two digit, so 65. So 6 we are going to round it. So 5 is more than, yes. So look at this, so 65, so 60, 61, 62, 63, and down also we have 6, 7, 8. So 5 is more than, so we are adding 1 to the tens place and the ones place remains 0. So the nearest value of 1765 is 1770. I hope you all understood how to find the nearest tens. Let we start how to find the nearest 100. Let take an example, 1735. Now look at the 100 place, that is 7. The next find place is tens is 3. So long way to reach 9. So hundreds place would not change. So the nearest value of 1735 is 1700. We can see the last two digit remains 0 because we are rounding the number to the nearest 100. So that will be 100, 200, 300, 400, 500 till 900. Let we take another example, 1765. Nearest 100, so hundreds place is 7 and tens place is 6. The tens place is more than 5. So we are adding 1 to the hundreds place. Yes, okay. So when you are adding 1 to the hundreds place, that become 8. So the remaining place become 0. So rounded number 1765 is 1800. I hope you all understood. Now the next concept, rounding to the nearest 1000. Example 2376. Now look at the thousands place, it's 2. And look at the next find place, it's 3. So 3 is lesser than 5. So we are going to keep that digit as same. So that becomes 2. Now the nearest 1000 of 2376 become 2000. The remaining digits are 0 because we are finding the nearest 1000. So that becomes 1000 or 2000 or 3000 or etc. Let we round off 37,821 to the nearest 1000. Look at the thousands place, that is 7. The next digit is 100, that is 8. Now 8 is greater than 5, so we are adding 1 to the thousands place, 7 plus 1, 8. So that is 38,000. So 37,821 is nearest to 38,000. Are you all clear, children? So when you are finding the nearest place of something, you need to look at the next find place. If it is more than 5, you need to add 1 in the particular place. If it is less than 5, you need to add 0 in the particular place. Are you all clear, children? That's all about rounding numbers. Just try finding rounding numbers by your own number. Thank you so much. Have a nice day ahead.